Hi there, folks. Welcome to another Tuesday with me. How are you? I have been blowing my nose all day. Don't know if you can tell, but I've had a cold. Yet, here I am. I'm here. And I hope that the week has treated you well. On to this week's questions. This is a tricky one. It's a tricky one to answer. I'm going to initially say I define the parts of my life that are connected with being trans based on my transgender status. I'm lots of things. I'm a comic geek. I'm British. I'm a socialist. I'm a wife. I'm hungry. I'm committed. I should be committed. That was this week's movie quote. Where's it from? Yeah, and I'm also trans. That's another part of me. So it's always there. The longer I go after transition, I don't want to say the smaller part of my life it becomes, but the less all-consuming in my life being trans becomes. It becomes something I maybe have to take more deliberate steps to keep myself connected with, because I do seem to have mostly passing privilege. I definitely have the privilege of being defined as female, fitting into that male-female binary. I have that privilege. And so I have to remind myself I'm part of this community. Not to say that it's not always there, because it is always there. It informs everything I do because it's a part of my life and of my experience. But I'd say there are times in my life when it comes up that I'm trans. And at those points, it becomes pretty important to me because I'm aware that it's often in social situations not something that other people necessarily who I'm mixing with will have experience of. To give an example, at work recently we've had an event, the university that I work at has had events for International Women's Day, and we've had certain speakers who are very publicly anti-trans come along, and when the topic of that arises amid the student staff that we employ, some of whom I'm in charge of on days at work. I'm aware as a trans person, even though they don't know I'm trans, I have to kind of add to the conversation in a way that brings up actual experience of trans issues. I have to, by stealth, educate people on trans stuff during those kinds of conversations. And at that point, it's very preeminent in my head. So it's something that I feel I have a responsibility to and something that is always there. But then, so are lots of other things about me. It's one thing among many. That doesn't mean it's not vitally important. So that's my answer to that part. I couldn't think of any more interesting ways to organise this video and to shoot it. And I like to do quirky, fun things with how I organise my video, and I'm sorry I couldn't this week, but I promise I'll try harder next week. On to the next question. To begin with, everyone, every single person who's ever posted for this channel, rock. You know, everyone. There have been so many great people, and as you guys will no doubt know, I hate making lists. I hate picking a top 5 or a top 10 or a favourite, because it means discarding everybody else. So this is tricky. So please, when I give the answer that I'm going to give, and I am going to give a particular answer, don't think that everybody else isn't cool as well, because there are so many people I could say are so cool for so many reasons. Just go back after watching this video at the older videos on the channel and appreciate all the really cool people who've posted and who unfortunately aren't posting with us right now. My answer to this question is, and I guess maybe a lot of other people are going to say this, but Leith and Les. Absolutely. If I had to pick a favourite TSG alumni, they. Absolutely. Why? Because they were just so fun. I looked forward to the video every week so much, and I loved, remember the Christmas video they did with the dog, and the dog as Mary, and all of that. I showed that, my entire family had fun watching that Christmas. So for their sheer sense of fun, and because that's something I wish I could bring into the world more than I do, and I wish I could bring to the channel more than I do. I think their lightheartedness and that, like I said, that sense of fun really is something that personally connected with me. And that's why they're favourites of mine. And because who doesn't dig couples? You know, I'm a big softie and a romantic at heart, so that was lovely too. That was my answer. You guys take care. Have a really good week, and I will see you next week if I survive work, because boy, it's hectic. This is completely off topic and completely inappropriate for me to say, but those of you who are at university, please be gentle to the non-university student staff who work at your unis. Please, just be gentle to us, because it can be tiring trying to help you all the time, and we can't always meet all of your needs, but we try. Send me a hug, everyone, and see you next week. Have a good week, and have fun. Take care, guys. Bye.